Okay, I think we're live. But I don't really know. I'll check on my iPad. Okay, yes, we are live. So I'm gonna wait until we have a few people in here. Oh, and I think I can see the, good morning. I can see the chat box as well. Okay, so can you guys hear me okay? I'm gonna change the video just a tad. I haven't done a live one on YouTube in a while, so yay, awesome. Okay, so I'm gonna head over to Facebook really quick and just send them a note saying that I'm live on YouTube now. Let's see. Good morning. Okay, so maybe this will help you make your decision. Although I think almost everything in this catalog, I've almost already shown you on my haul videos, but I've done these walkthroughs with the catalogs for several years, so I'm not gonna skip it this year. So this will be a quick video. We are not making a project. I'm not doing a giveaway. I'm just gonna do a really quick walkthrough of the catalog. I do really, really, really love it. And I think the projects that I've been making are just so cute. So this is the cover. It's very elegant this year. And then on the inside, I wanna make sure that everybody sees, you know, this punch box. I said this on my haul video, that this punch is actually different from the box that's in our annual catalog. And I do really like even these images as well. So I'll make sure I use those as we get closer to Christmas. Right now we're still really into the Halloween things. And the next page is the Merry to All. And I did grab some of the projects that I've made. So this is one of the projects I made using the Happy, and then I used the Halloween from another stamp set. I think it's like the Penance or something like that. So if you want to see what the potential is for this set, and at first I wasn't even thinking I was going to order this set. I did get it for free on the incentive trip, but I do actually really like it, so yay. And you can pair this up with even a happy birthday, even though I don't think birthday's on here. No, it's not. So you could use it for any occasion. Okay, so let me flip the page. And this embossing folder, I don't think you've seen me use it yet, but it really is so beautiful. And you can see it really clearly in this picture right here. Okay, so on the next page, oh, I wish I had my sample. I don't know where I stashed it. We actually made this card with a slight change to it at a team meeting. Chad Williams came and was at the meeting with us. It was pretty awesome. So everything on this page I have, but I have not yet used it because, well, I did at the meeting, but I've not really made any exclusive projects. Yeah, I haven't. I pretty much made mostly Halloween. But I do like it, and I love the fonts, and I love all the greetings. On the next page, we have Dashing Deer, and I did get this on the incentive trip as well. I have tried to use this a couple times, and I've not had success yet because I love this larger deer, but it needs a bigger box or a bigger project. So it's a great image for a card because it will pretty much fill up the entire space, which you can see here on this sample here. And I could use one of the smaller ones, but I just love how elegant and pretty that one is. So I'm gonna try to create something with it. I did get this one, have not touched it, but I got this one because of the framelits. I love this framelit right here, And if you look really closely on this sample, I think if you guys look really closely at the samples in this catalog, it kind of sells you on all of the product. So that really pretty framelit is why I got this one. I think that's going to make a beautiful Christmas card. I skipped on this one because it just kind of wasn't my style. I do think it's super cute. I think these presents are darling. But I wasn't sure I would use it. So I skipped on it. This one, love, 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 love. And you guys saw me use, what did I make the other day? Where is that project? I didn't grab that one. Oh, I showed it yesterday. It should be right here. Here it is. Yeah, this one. So it's using this stamp set. But I didn't use the framelits with it. But that's okay. Love everything. The ribbon, I use that on what? I don't know. This was an exclusive to my newsletter subscribers. So I'll just give you a little sneak peek at it. Look, I sent this out last week. So stinking cute. So I used the striped burlap ribbon, but I trimmed off half of it. Okay? There's just so much to talk about on this page. This corrugated embossing folder. If you look here on this card, you can see it. You can see it on this card. I love everything. I didn't order anything on this page except for the blends. So these are new ones. Usually we have the word new beside items, or that's what we've had in the annual catalog. But these are new, and all of them in this catalog are new. So Real Red and Shaded Spruce is on this page, and then later we'll see some other ones. I did not get anything on these two pages either, but I am going to break down and get this one. It just, there's something about it that makes me want it. But I'm holding off for a little while. Love, love, love. Y'all saw this one on the little tag I made. I just love the framelits are used to cut out the images on the designer series paper. And these are on back order already because they are so stinking cute. So all these little guys that's on the paper, you can cut them out with the framelits. I felt like a kid using them. And then on the Santa's Workshop enamel shapes, although that's Real Red, I took my Cherry Cobbler Stampin' Blend and colored it Cherry Cobbler. It took like three coats. So love those. I have not used the Santa bags yet other than to give away some chick stands. After the wedding, I'll get back to my giving, and I do need to draw some names. Red rhinestones, those are good, but those are in the annual catalog, so that's not new. Okay, next page. Did I get that? I did get it because I tried using that. I was trying to use that bow on this project the other day, and it was way too big, so I went with the enamel shape. But that is really cute too. This one I showed on my haul. Y'all have really seriously got to look at that one. It is really awesome for card making, not just for memory keeping. So I went through every one of them on the haul video. So that's a really cute one. And if you need the link to the haul video, let me know. Did I get this one? I didn't. I didn't get anything on this page. Although this one kind of speaks to me, but I'm trying to do much better. I did get So Santa. I just couldn't resist. It's just too funny of a set, so I'm going to have to use it. Especially Ho Ho Ho, Who Needs Snow? I think I might use that with my snowman soup this year. Okay, so now, tags and tidings. So I think, of course I told y'all, I love, love, love of that, and that's where this greeting came from, is right there. And let me show you a couple other Well, I have one that I'm going to show next week. So what I did was, is I took this whole entire thing and I did my Versamark and then my white embossing powder. And I did the whole entire thing. So I have all of these embossed on cherry cobbler. So I know some of you have been confused about this because I've gotten a couple emails. You can just ink up part of it, or you can ink up the whole thing and the framelit fits right over top and cuts all of them at one time. Or you can just cut a section if you want. So if you just wanted to, you know, do these three, I like having all of them over there on my desk so that when I'm making projects, I can see, oh, well, this works and it doesn't work. Because originally I was thinking about using it on here. And anyway, so make one and cut them and set them aside. And when you're creating, you can see if it works. So love, love, love. The Sweetly Stitched Framelits, again, that was the exclusive project for my newsletter subscriber. So that's this tree here. I didn't even use the stamp set. I just used the framelits, but I'm going to use the stamp set. I love it. There's something about it that reminds me of the catalog when I joined in 2002. Something about these images just kind of remind me of back then. I did not get anything on this page. I did get this one. And I don't think I've touched it yet. Nope, I haven't, but I will. I love the tree. I love these trees. And this greeting is really awesome. Good morning, for those of you that are just arriving. Okay, so page 29. Yep, I got it all. But I don't know why I keep apologizing. The catalog just went live. So yes, I have not used it yet. But I think I used one of these papers on something. I don't remember what. It could be something down the pike. Did I get that one? I don't think so. I didn't, but I kind of want to because these birds are super cute. And I like the season's greeting. And I love the gift of your friendship means so much, especially at Christmas. That's so... Maybe I did get it. I don't know. I have to look back on my shelf over there. I'm at my filming station now instead of my workstation. I can't even see my desk over there. The Take Your Pick tool is available now. I don't have it here at my desk, but I do keep the extra piece on one of my older Chick stands. So if you have an extra Chick stand, you can just store the other piece of it in your Chick stand. The refill is on back order, but it'll be in later. But you already get that in your thing, so you don't have to worry about getting a refill now. I don't think it's going to go anywhere. It's a pretty awesome tool. It's very similar to the Quick Stick that I used years ago. Well, I still used it recently. I did not get anything on this page, but I kind of want it. I really want this one, but I just... When I look through the catalog, it's like, what will I realistically use between now and Christmas? So I passed. Love this one. These tags are so cute. I've got to make them. I think maybe I'm going to do this on a Facebook Live. On this one, I did not get the kit, but I did get the stamp set. And I really do like the stamp set. There's just something about it, too. Like, I love this poinsettia, and I love this tree right here. I just think it's going to be easy for a simple project. Okay, this one I got. I've not used it yet, but I do like it as well. I'll tell you that the samples on this page completely sold me on this. I can totally see making a really simple, elegant Thanksgiving card with this one. Kind of like how this card is here, but more in like earthy tones, neutrals maybe. page 37, I can't remember if I got the stamp set. I think maybe I passed on the stamp set. I marked my calendar. I mark my catalog normally when I purchase them, so I have a big check mark. But that catalog is upstairs, and I'm just using an extra one now. So I know I got the paper and everything else. These clear epoxy droplets I'm going to be using on a project later this week, on a Halloween project. So they're frosted and clear. I'm using the clear on one of the cards I'm going to be showing. It's the Cauldron Bubble Stamp Kit of the Month card. I think it's card number 2. Of course, I got this whole page. Can't wait to use it. Yes. And I got this one too, because how could I not? Especially this thinlet die. It cuts out those snowflakes. It's so beautiful. And I'll get to use my shimmer paint. Isn't this box so beautiful? So they stamped that check, Buffalo check, on the box and then decorated it. Whew. I need to use this box for Halloween. Just saying. I did not get this one. I did get this whole page. I have used this one already, but y'all haven't seen it yet. And I have tried to use this one, and I have failed. I stamped him, her. It looks like a she to me. I've stamped her in basic black, basic gray, early espresso. What's that new gray color? Gray granite. And it just, I don't know. I'm not sure what to do with it yet. I'm not giving up, but because I think it's going to be super cute for Halloween, but I was just really struggling with how to make it more spooky. I don't know. Once the wedding is done, my real brain will return, I think. And oh my gosh, this one is so beautiful. I've seen so many cute samples. I love, love, love the galvanized paper, the chicken wire elements. This whole bundle is really awesome. The paper too. And here's some more Stampin' Blends. So the tin tile, if you look down here, because it's in that green color, to me, looks a little invisible, but you can really see it here on the galvanized metal. So that is just wow. Yeah. Hopefully y'all have checked that out. On page 44, I did not get that one, but I did get page 45. I'm thinking ahead to my blessing mix box, and I don't know if I'm going to use this one or that other one that I said in the earth. Well, I could use this one for my blessing mix as well. Maybe I should make multiple this year. I could do that, you know. I don't know why I don't. I think I just go straight from Halloween to Christmas. I don't know where it was. Anyway, so love this one as well. On this page, of course I got this. How could I not? It's really cute, but I have not used it. And Making Every Day Bright. I got it because, of course, it's got a little Easter, Halloween. But these things are super small. So if you're looking for something really little, that's good. Yeah. Okay. Yay. I've shown y'all a ton of stuff with this already. Let's see. This one. I think this might have been the first project I showed. And then this one was last week. So that's Cauldron Bubble. This is my Stamp Kit of the Month. So those of you that did Stamp Kit of the Month last month, it's going to work the exact same way. I just need to get the price out there and all the details. So in the next couple days. But you're going to see Cauldron Bubble Stamp Kit of the Month, Stamp Kit of the Month card number 1. And we're using the ribbon and the spider trinkets, and that's as much as I remember. Or maybe that's card, no, that's card 1. And then card 2 is using the ribbon. Maybe that's it. I don't know. Anyway, love this page. Love all of it. And the black foil sheets. And you guys have seen me use this one along with, so the little ghost here, and the framelits, and then I paired it with this stamp set here, the takeout treats, and I love the takeout treat box. I love framelits, but for some reason, I've used this stamp set more than I haven't even used the framelits yet. I'm going to, though. They're awesome. And it makes the cutest little box. What else is, I've used something else on here. Maybe some Christmas cheer for you. But this can be Valentine's, Christmas, and Halloween, anytime. Yeah. That's so cute, isn't it? And then trick or tweet. That stumps me every time. So y'all saw the cat here and the greeting. What else? Have I used it again? I thought I had. I don't know. And then spooky sweets. So I used the Bat Punch on this project. And I used, let's see, the No Tricks or Just Treats for this one. So I used a combination of Cauldron Bubble and Spooky Sweets. Yeah. If y'all were to ask me what was my favorite Halloween, we'd start here, but I don't think that I could manage without having all of these. Like, I really have, I think I've done a pretty good job of using this one, and this one with a combination of this one. So yeah, if you ask me, I'd say all of them. And as of today, we can finally get our hands on the Hostess sets. So I started up my Stampin' Rewards Club, and everyone just takes turns getting Hostess benefits. I explained earlier that the annual catalog and the holiday catalog, the Hostess sets are really pretty fabulous. And in the past, I've kind of sort of not used them because, well, people can't get them unless you place a large order or have a workshop. And so I'm gonna use this one because it's super cute. This one's really pretty. I love that one too. So I'm putting a plug in for Stampin' Rewards Club. All it is you place a minimum order and you take turns getting the Hostess benefits or the Stampin' Rewards. Hostess benefits, Stampin' Rewards, it means the exact same thing. It's just Hostess benefits used to be the term we used to use, and it changed a few years back, and now it's Stampin' Rewards. So that's why I named it Stampin' Rewards Club. Okay, so let's look a little closer at this this Hostess set, which is called Warm Hearted. If you look at the samples, look at this beautiful thanks, and look at the beautiful Merry Christmas with the little, again, I'm gonna say look at the samples, because if you look at the stamp set, sometimes you don't really see the potential, and then you look up here and it's like, that is so elegant, so beautiful. And the same thing with this stamp set too. Look at this. I love this one. I love that one too. You'll have to use your Stamparatus to line that thing up. Okay, so that wraps up the entire catalog. I'll be doing the exact same thing this evening at 7 o'clock over on Facebook. Do you guys have any questions this morning? I'm gonna pick up my iPad and see. I think you guys have, hopefully y'all are still there. Y'all are still there, right? Let me open it up to a page so that, you're welcome. I haven't done this on YouTube in a really long time, so I'm gonna start doing them more regularly after the wedding. So I will get better. I feel a little rusty in doing this, but it looks like I think last time I did it, I couldn't see the comments and I felt really disorganized and lost, but I can see y'all's comments. You can hear me, right? Still? I'm still here? Because I have a lag on my video. Like, my hands are not moving. It's a serious lag. Yes. Okay. Thank you, Sandy. Okay. Well, if you guys have any questions, let me know. Thank you guys for watching my holiday catalog walkthrough. And if you have any questions, feel free to send me an email. Oh, let me put this back in here. Okay. Y'all have a great day. Thank you. I don't know how to stop the video, though. That's interesting. I'm gonna have to put my hands in front of the camera. Sorry, guys.